So here you see the classic case. The good root, and then we have to trim just to the point where the roots are or rotten, right, or stringy. So remove all the dead roots as much as possible, right? So even if in the process we lose a couple of good roots, don't worry about it, it will grow back, right? On the other hand, if you leave a couple of bad roots, that will ensure the infection will spread, right? So the infection will spread by just splashing of water. When you water the plant from a good root, from a bad root, to if it splashes, especially under the period of stress, like what I told you earlier, right? So as much as possible under the period of stress, so the good roots also tend to be under stress, right? And any kind of infection, if it splashes and touches the plant, it will take down the plant, right? Slowly, it wouldn't happen. So here is again, you see a classic case, right? So good root, and then there is a bad root at the end. Don't worry about it, just snip it. So if it is yellow, don't worry, you can trim it. If it is green, you can leave it. If it is yellow, you go ahead and trim it. Right, so be careful, especially in the basket, right? Look inside the basket and then trim. So here is where, like what I said, we have to be careful at the base of the plant, that the roots in the base of the plant are clean and neat, right? So I'll remove whichever are bad, right? So now just turn around the plant. Here again, snap. Snap. Base of the plant. Right, so here again, I will cut maybe till there. And then remove the dead ones. So here again, another classic root trim. Trim. So don't allow any of these brown roots to stay. Don't worry, they will grow back. So now we see that all I am left with is roots that are green, right? So now we are good. So the same thing I will do for the other plants.